Item acquired.
Oh, what am I thinking? Of course he's not here.
Huh?
Oh, I beg your pardon, sweetie. Who did you say you were again?
We're here to see if Jules is home.
Oh my! Are you friends of Jules? I'm Jules's mother, Pamela. It's a pleasure to meet any friend of Jules. Please, do come in!
Oh, actually, we were...
Oh, I insist. You really must come inside. I will not allow any of Jules's to stand outside like strangers.
Well, you heard, lady.
Jules, your friends are here!
My friends? Oh, it's you.
Imagine my delight when I met all of your wonderful friends. Don't mind me. I'll just be over here preparing a pot of tea.
You don't have to, ma'am.
Don't bother.
Why's that?
She's always like this with guests. There's no talking her out of it. I'd appreciate it if you'd humor her by sticking around for a while.
Sure, we don't mind.
Why not? Might as well.
Thanks. So, what did you want to see me for? My notebook. You came just to give this to me? Sorry for the trouble. But I guess we're even since you peeked inside. A small slip of paper in it so I could tell if it was opened. And now, it's missing. And it looks like the answer to the mystery is written on her face.
That's a pretty nifty trick.
For a kid, maybe.
You had good intentions, so I'll let you off the hook this time.
Jules.
What?
You're the renegade, aren't you? Wait, what?
And what makes you think that?
I thought I recognized your voice from somewhere. And how many boys your age speak the way you do?
It wasn't my intention to mislead. Not like what the White Cat was doing. And I'm certainly not going as far as hiding my real identity like the Crimson King.
A swift confession.
Maybe I should have thought twice about speaking to you at the Cultural Heritage Site. I knew you'd all find out eventually, but it's not any less troublesome.
Now, you haven't seemed troublesome till I've asked you all my questions. Hope you're ready. First question. What's that wheelchair for?
This? I was never able to stand on my legs.
Really?
No kidding.
No, I've just had a weak constitution ever since I was young. I'm sure this was going to be your next question, so I'll just answer it for you. Nobody knows what my disease is. They said it was incurable. Even the top doctors in Bald Duke gave up on finding a cure. As time goes on, my body gets weaker. I'm told I'll be lucky to live to 20.
Are you serious?
Unfortunately, joking isn't one of my strong suits. All I know is that when I become the Renegade, I can move my body again. I have Aprilis to thank for that.
I'm sorry. I had no idea you were going through something so terrible.
If you don't mind, I have a request for you all. I don't want you to feel sorry for me. Just treat me like you treat anybody else. I'm tired of people walking on eggshells around me just because I'm sick.
I don't blame you.
But don't get me wrong. I assure you that it's not like I've abandoned my will to live. But after being frustrated with my body for so long, I've accepted it, and that I should live and die in my own body, on my own terms. To that end, I wish to leave this world without any regrets. That's all there is to it.
Jules. Then that Nails in the Coffin notebook we found.
That's right. It's my bucket list. The name was to remind myself that I need to finish it before I go six under.
I want to do everything I can to help.
I'm sure you do. But I have to respectfully decline.
Yeah, I thought you would.
Otherwise, I'd just be using my disease as an excuse to get people to do things for me. I'd like to do it on my own. So you can just leave me be.
Ouch.
If that's what you want. That's right. Maybe not by choice at first, but Adol's got a point, you know? If you think of anything we can help with, you know where to find us, okay?
I doubt I will, but I'll keep that in mind. By the way, that ghost at the cultural heritage site you've been looking for? That's me.
You were the ghost?
More and more people have been desecrating those ruins lately, so I used my gift to scare them off. That official claimed she was investigating, but she was only adding to the damage. I have a hunch she learned her lesson.
Thank you.
Jules.
We've just gotta act normal, okay?
Hey.
Yes?
Do you think the barrier at the gate will disappear once the Full Moon Grimwald is over?
Who knows? Maybe it will, but maybe it won't.
It won't be easy, but as long as we act normal, we can get through this together.
Huh? Sure.
What are those goofballs doing?
It appears they are overcompensating.
What a mess. Alright, Adol. Now that the tension's been broken, let's get on with this.
Monstrums, the time is nigh. Under the red moons, the wicked and the defiant shall be punished. Ascend into this unbreaking night. Unsheathe your curse and smite the darkness.
Yeah. Tougher than I would have liked.
The full moon Grimwald really has a kick to it, huh?
The battles are rather arduous. I feel a crick in my joints. There we are. I may require recalibrations later.
Are the Rheindahls the ones who help you with that?
Yes, while I am in my doll form. But Rodario only repairs me when Melissa is absent.
He's probably afraid Mrs. Rheindahl will tease him about it.
Perhaps. But he is a skillful craftsman and treats me with great care. I'd prefer not to be any more of a burden to them than I already am.
Krisha!
What? Aprilis!
Calm yourself. It's nothing.
But your arm!
I can always change it with another. Are you hurt?
No, I'm okay.
It was my fault. I should have it coming.
As long as you're both all right. Now that the full moon Grimwald has passed, the curse should have been altered.
Last time, the barrier at the west gate opened, allowing us to leave the city walls.
I wouldn't mind if we could go even farther this time.
You can say that again. Let's take a look when we get back to town.
Shadow die!
Treasure chest!
Treasure chest.
Shadow Dog! A treasure chest!
trap